fact is made in front, our animal style, the sea lion. And last but not least, I cannot do this presentation alone. I'm going to need the help from one brave, young volunteer. So all you got to do for me is raise that hand up in the air and show me.
Microphone isn't working.
What did I do now?
What's going on? I know, he said
saw something big, something scary.
This one. Did I see anything in the pool?
No.
No? Okay, let me fill it. I'll check for you, okay? I'm in a good mood. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt here. I'm going to check for you. Why are you guys doing it? He doesn't believe me. He's checking it on his own. No, let's go. The shark will be out of the box. You can stay. If there was a shark in the boat, you'd have to let it fill it. Not the joke. Let's turn it up. The sea. Applause. because he knows he gets a whole lot more fish for a job. Well done. Oh my gosh, look at the jackpot. He gets all these lovely fish. Oh, it's not playing around. Nice to hear you as well. Thank you very much, Philip. Excellent job as always. But first, folks, one more thing so far. But right now, I'm going to get a little serious here. Philip, he wants to send across a very important message on how we can go about making this environment and Earth a much greener and better place to live in. Now, we're going to talk about a very serious issue right now, which is the ocean's deadliest monster. We all know it's plastic, more specifically, the single-use plastic. Now, sea lions, turtles, and dolphins are some of the mammals that actually mistake plastic floating on the water as food, and they often swallow pretty easily, choke, and die as a result from it. So, what we can do on our part is many things, but this plastic alone is not the cause of a lot of great damage out there. Another thing would be fishing lines that often get entangled around the sea lion's flippers and even necks. So right now, let's see what happens when it gets caught on your flipper, buddy. There you go. Not a very nice sight, is it? But a more fatal one would be the fishing nets that often get caught around your necks. And Philip, what happens when you get caught around your neck? Gets caught around your neck, buddy? That's right, they drown, people, they drown. Oscar performance day, Oscar winning performance, as always. So thank you very much. Believe it or not, plastic waste and all these fishing lines and nets are the cause of millions of deaths every year. But we, to be true conservationists, you guys, we can do our part by practicing the three important R's. The first R we have is to reduce. So we can reduce our waste by opting for more sustainable alternatives like your canvas bag and the Abba's got earlier instead of your plastic bags when you do your grocery shopping. Now we all know the next R is called reuse. Now reuse, we can often use reusable bottles instead of buying those bottles from your various convenience stores. Now you can get one of these actually in any of the kiosks here at the Singapore Zoo, subject to availability, and you can top them up at all the various refillable stations scattered around the zoo as well, which saves you tons of money, might I add. Okay. Now the most famous R we have is recycle. So to demonstrate this, I think Philip's going to show us how it's done. Here you go. So you got your plastic waste, what do? Next, buddy. You got your nearest recycling bin and toss it away. As simple as that, you guys. A simple act can go a really, really long way. I hope you can stay with us from here. And I'll have to take your face today. All right, now we're going to end this off with a bang. I think it's about time for sure. Then what you got, Philip?